Hello children, let us continue with our second chapter of Math 2, that is parallel lines. Students, our today's topic is use of properties of parallel lines and test for parallel lines. Let us prove a property of a triangle using the properties of angles made by a transversal of parallel lines. So, first theorem is the sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. This is the property of a triangle. The sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Okay. So, what is given in this statement? One triangle is given and you have to prove that sum of measure of all angles of that triangle is 180 degree. So, theorem is the sum of measures of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So, what is given? Triangle ABC is any triangle. Triangle ABC is any triangle. What you have to prove? Angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC equal to 180 degree. The sum of measure of all angles is 180 degree. Means to prove angle ABC, angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle ACB plus angle BAC plus angle BAC is equal to 180 degree. In this theorem, there is one construction. And what is that construction? Draw a line parallel to seg BC and passing through A. On the line, take points P and Q such that P dash A dash Q. What is your construction? Draw a line parallel to seg BC passing through point A. On the line, take points P and Q such that P dash A dash Q. So, this is your construction. Now, proof. Line PQ parallel to line BC and seg AB is a transversal. Line PQ is parallel to line BC and seg AB is a transversal. PQ parallel to BC and AB is a transversal. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to angle PAB. Therefore, angle ABC, these are two parallel lines and this is your transversal. So, angle ABC is equal to angle PAB. This angle ABC is equal to angle PAB. Why? These are which type of angles? Alternate angles. Therefore, angle ABC is equal to angle PAB. Reason is alternate angle. This is your equation 1. Now, next. Line PQ is parallel to line BC and seg AC is a transversal. Again, PQ is parallel to BC but AC is a transversal. Seg AC is a transversal. Therefore, angle ACB equal to angle QAC. Therefore, angle ACB equal to QAC. Parallel line, this is transversal. So, this angle is equal to this angle. Therefore, angle ACB is equal to angle QAC. Angle ACB is equal to angle QAC. Again, reason is alternate angles. And this is your equation 2. Now from 1 and 2, add equation 1 and 2. So angle ABC plus angle ACB, angle ABC plus angle ACB equal to angle PAB plus angle QAC, angle PAB plus angle QAC. Add LHS with LHS and RHS with RHS. So from 1 and 2, angle ABC plus angle ACB equal to angle PAB plus angle QAC. This is your third equation. Now next step is adding angle BAC to both sides of equation 3. Add angle BAC to both sides of equation 3. Therefore, angle ABC plus ACB. Angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC. Add angle BAC equal to PAB plus QAC. PAB plus QAC plus angle BAC. So angle ABC plus angle ACB plus angle BAC equal to angle PAB plus angle QAC plus angle BAC, adding angle BAC to both sides of equation 3. Now again rewrite this. Angle PAB plus angle BAC plus angle QAC, angle PAB plus angle BAC plus angle QAC. But angle PAB plus angle BAC is PAC. Angle PAB plus angle BAC, PAB plus angle BAC is angle PAC. See here, PAB plus BAC, PAB plus BAC. This angle, angle PAB plus angle PAC is your angle PAC, is your angle PAC. So PAB plus angle BAC is PAC plus angle QAC plus angle QAC, since PAB plus BAC is equal to angle PAC. But PAC plus QAC is equal to 180 degree angles in a linear pair. PAC plus QAC, PAC, this angle PAC plus QAC equal to 180 degree angles in a linear pair. Angles in a linear pair. Therefore, PAC plus QAC equal to 180 degree. Reason is angles in a linear pair. That is, sum of measures of all three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Sum of measures of all three angles of a triangle is 180 degree.